everyone, and thanks for joining us on this installment of ECCS Live. We have a wide variety of news and announcements for you guys coming at you today. So we hope that you stay tuned and enjoy the show. So let's just jump right into it. First things first, we have ECCS Live, which you're watching right now. So we decided to start a new campaign called hashtag ECCS Live. And basically what we want you to do is to take selfies of yourself watching our show. Okay, so you can be while you're sitting there, while you're sitting at home watching the show, or when you're here at the center watching, you just take a selfie.
Yeah. There we go. All right, I'm done. I'm done.
All right. So
you want your own? You want your own?
No.
Yeah, you do. Oh, there you go. Ah, there
All
we
right.
go. Yeah.
Can't pass up a good
selfie. Sorry.
Anyway, so what we want you to do is definitely to take pictures of yourself, right? Selfies, and this can be you and your parents. If you want to get together with some of your friends or with the teachers, and just take a selfie of you guys watching ECCS Live. Then what you're going to do is that you're going to check out our Facebook, right? At Esperanza Cyber, right? Or Facebook slash Esperanza Cyber. Our Twitter, right? Which is at Esperanza Cyber 1. Or on YouTube at Esperanza Cyber as well.
Right.
Right. And we want you to post these pictures with the hashtag ECCS Live, mm-hmm. and we're going to start using these photos everywhere, right? It'll be great advertisement. We'll post it up on Facebook so everyone can see you. And we're just going to have this nice little kind of campaign. Mm-hmm. And you'll be seeing my photo, right? That photo that we just took, and maybe the other 50 that Mr. Estrada took. Those will probably be up there as well.
Yeah.
So definitely make sure you're staying tuned to ECCS Live, and make sure you're tagging us.
Yep.
Right? Now, there was some talk of a ban last week,
right?
And I think I kind of got roped into it, but I'm not sure.
Yeah, so we're going to get a ban together, as you might know from last week.
Okay.
We're still you know, trying to finish up on seeing who's coming, who's going to be in the band. It's a very exclusive right, you know what I mean?
Uh-huh.
Not everyone can be in the ECCS Live band. And that's just a temporary name.
We don't have a name.
So if you remember last week, what we try to do is ask for suggestions. So again, I just want to remind you, hit us up at EsperanzaCyber1, give us your suggestion, and then type in hashtag ECCS Live.
Yeah.
And that's about it on that.
I think I have a lot of great names.
You got some good names? We've had a couple of suggestions. What we'll do is we'll get like maybe four or five and that we think are the, you know, one of the better ones, and then we'll have the whole school pick on which is the best one. And then after that, once we get the name, then you will see us in all of our glory.
That's right. I sing.
I sing. And like I said, I also sing better than Mr. Christie.
Mr. Christie, yes, I've heard this.
Mr. Christie thinks he can sing. He hasn't. He has not heard me sing. I keep that. I keep that bottled inside.
You know, you throw out a lot of challenges to Christie.
I do. Yeah. I do, because I'm better than him.
All right.
In singing and in running.
I think I got a few good names. You know, I got like the Technotones.
Oh, the Technotones.
8 bits equal a byte.
You know this guy's technology. The technology.
The keyboards. Get it? The keyboards? Because
that's not even catchy.
Anyway.
Yeah.
Anyway. So make sure you're posting up your names on Facebook and Twitter. With the hashtag ECCS band.
Yep.
So we're going to take a quick break, and right when we come back, we're going to have Mr. Hymish join us for a small segment of kind of more current events that are coming up. Right? So make sure you stay tuned. Hey, and welcome back. I'm here joined by Mr. Hymas, right?
Yes, sir. Yes.
Mr. Hymas, tell me what you do. What do you do here at ECCS?
All right. Well, this year I'm an outreach coordinator. Mm-hmm. With that, it just basically I'm trying to throw out our name to the community, trying to involve myself in community events, provide community events for yourselves, for your families, volunteering events,
mm-hmm. okay.
also possible internships and jobs, but that's still up in the air right now. And for instance, today I actually just came from a volunteering opportunity, just giving free trees away to anybody that wanted them.
Free trees?
Yeah.
Yeah?
Yeah, about 50. You probably get around 40 away today.
Yeah? Can I have one in my office?
Yeah, they close at 2. So if you need one, you can actually go on Thursday. But when it comes to the office, no, because they're actually all yard trees. So you have to plant them in the yard. Yeah. Okay.
Well, that's unfortunate.
Yeah.
But if you want a free tree, up to 2 o'clock. Yes. So you are outreach, right? You do a lot of things in the community. You do a lot of things here at the center.
Yes.
What are some upcoming events? Are there any upcoming events that you have kind of in the works right now?
Yeah, there are a few. One thing is if you guys come to the center, you guys probably saw this little packet. And if you don't see it, just let me know. Send me an email, ehymus@esperanzacybercs.net, and I can provide you with this list. And this list is basically, if you are on Access Card or EBT, you can actually go to 17 different gardens and museums here in Philadelphia that give you a $2 entrance fee as opposed to a $10, $15, or even more. Wow. Doesn't include any special events or exhibits.
Yeah.
So, anywho, with that, also on the 19th, we have an annual Philadelphia AIDS walk that happens here near Kelly Drive. And this year I'm actually trying to create a team for ECCS. So I am inviting yourselves, I'm inviting staff, anybody that wants to join and represent us on the walk. We would like to donate some money, and it's going to be a registration. No registration fee, but to register your name and then possibly get a shirt if we get there on time. And just walk together, throw awareness out there, and it's a good opportunity to just come together, enjoy a nice little stroll in the park. And
that's great. Have you done this walk before?
Yeah. I did it in New York probably 3 years. It's been a while, but I did like three years, and then Philadelphia probably did about 4 years. Not consecutive, but I do tend to do it.
Great. So that'll be a lot of fun. So if you need any questions or you want to be involved with the Philadelphia AIDS Walk to raise awareness, definitely contact Mr. Hymus. Yep. I'm going to try my best to get out there and walk as well.
One more thing I might add is when I get more information, when it comes to the registration information, which I'm waiting for through Google email, I will then relay that information to everybody via Google email also.
Great. And I hear we have a new club in the works.
Yes, this club. It's an awesome club. I will call it the Elite, I guess you can say. It's going to be an actual official club, and that club is known as a chess club.
Chess.
Chess club is just like any other club, Monday, 10 to 12. But the only difference is that I'm actually trying to make it into an official, actually competitive team. Women and men are all welcomed. Mm-hmm. Okay. 10 to 12, going to show you some lessons, going to partake in some tournaments, and they're all free. And it doesn't matter your experience level. As long as you know how to move the pieces, you're fine. You can partake and you can enjoy yourself and meet people from other parts of Philadelphia and even Pennsylvania. Depends on the severity of the tournament. I have a black queen here. A lot of females think that chess is a predominantly male sport, but it's not. And actually in the spring is going to start a Black Queen Academy downtown. So if any of you ladies want to start playing chess, you can start with me and then join that free academy, which actually is being run by a national competitor or ranked number one in the nation, female chess player. So it's actually pretty intense and cool. So
that's a great opportunity. So it's a lot of cool things all revolving around chess, but chess is a fun game.
Yes.
I like chess a lot. I play. And I don't think I'm okay, but I'm not that great.
Yeah.
I tell you who is really good, though. Mr. Estrada. He can play some chess. And I think if he was here, he would challenge you right now
probably
to a chess match.
Probably. He's so intimidating, though.
I'm going to do is I'm going to throw it out there for you.
Okay.
Mr. Estrada is going to challenge Mr. Hymus to a chess match to show how smart and witty he is. Okay?
Okay.
So there it is. Checkmate. Speaking of competition, right? So I'm not sure if you were aware, Mr. Estrada challenged Mr. Christie last week to a foot race.
Oh, so that was real? I thought that was just a rumor that was going on.
No, he challenged him to a foot race.
Wow.
And so ECCS Live was there on the scene. And let's just take a quick look at how that event turned out.
Yeah, sounds interesting.
Great. Stay with us. Gonna turn out?
Oh, I don't think. I already know.
Yeah?
Yeah, there's no doubt in my mind that I'm gonna win this race.
Yeah?
Oh, yeah.
Oh, okay.
How about you, big guy?
It's a little windy. It's not, you know, prime running condition. It's a little chilly. You know, I didn't know it was gonna be this cold. It's a little cold. I might be in a t-shirt and shorts, but it's really cold out here. I wasn't prepared. I mean, I'm not about excuses, but I'm just saying it's cold. I didn't get to have lunch today or breakfast. All I had was a pretzel with cheese in it and a cookie. That's not a complete breakfast or dinner or lunch. And I'm really hungry, so I just want to throw that out there. And don't judge off of like whatever performance you're going to see right now. Yeah, so, but I'm not scared. I'm not scared.
Ready, set, go!
Are you walking?
All right, Mr. Christie, we're done the race. You look perfectly fine. Don't look tired. How you feeling?
Feeling pretty good. I'm ready to go to Disney World.
Yeah?
Yep.
All right, let's check on Mr. Estrada. Hey, are you all right there, buddy?
This should teach you to eat your breakfast and your lunch and wear good sneakers and only run when there's good weather. In a little while, next year we'll do a run. But I think I should get a head start because I'm older. I don't know what you guys think, but I get around that.
Oh well, guys, there's the results. Mr. Christie the winner. Mr. Estrada, not so much.
Hey, buddy. So about that race. What happened, man?
Well, you see, what happened was I didn't get a good stretch, you know.
Oh, absolutely.
I didn't get to stretch. I didn't get to...
You eat breakfast that morning?
No, I didn't have breakfast.
See, that'll
didn't drink a Gatorade. Usually, you gotta have those things, you know, before you start race any type of, you know, athletic type of thing. You gotta have your Gatorade. You gotta have your, like again, some type of breakfast. You know, I ran out of bananas and oatmeal, and that's my Wheaties. Usually, I gotta have that before I race, but you know, I did it, and. You know, and then what ended up happening was I hurt like that back muscle, you know, like behind the leg, and then I also hurt a muscle in my neck, and then my tricep started getting pulled, and my wrist muscle.
And that affects the way you run.
It does. Yeah, man, you need all the muscles when you're running.
No, you're right, absolutely.
When you run like a gazelle, like me, if you don't have all your muscles off, you know, on point, you lose.
Absolutely.
You know, and
the wounded gazelle.
You know, I'm gonna be a good sport about it. You know, I'm not gonna say, you know, Christie did, you know, he did.
He drank Gatorade and he.
That's what it was. He drank Gatorade. I think the reason why he beat me was he had two Gatorades, and I think he might have had a Red Bull, and he told me he had a very good breakfast.
Okay.
He told me he had a really good breakfast, and he, we just weren't. I wasn't on my game. He apparently was on his game. And, you know, I think he cheated. If you rewind the film, you can see he got like a good 20-second head start.
So,
yeah. You were there.
I was there. You're right.
You didn't see it.
I...
Did you see it?
In other news, we have a new incentive going on. I'm just gonna save you now, buddy.
Yeah, all right.
So we have a new, we have a, an incentive, right? We're trying to bring more students into the school. We're calling it the tablet incentive.
Right, correct? Right.
You have some information on that?
Okay, so as many of you know, like what do we have right here?
Oh, is the, are these tablets?
These are tablets.
These are a form of tablets, right?
These are a form of tablet. You have your iPad. You have other tablets out there.
Kindles,
Surface, all that stuff, yeah, right?
Good.
And then you have other ones that Galaxy Tab.
The Galaxy Tabs. You have the Acer tablets, the Lenovo tablets.
Right.
You have tablets here, tablets there, everywhere.
Yeah. I thought you were about to start.
That singing. Song? No.
I thought you wanted to challenge me in the singing.
No.
You're better than me. All right.
Oh,
all right.
By the way, you challenged Jaimez to a chess match.
That's cute.
So the tablet incentive. Basically, what it is any student who recommends another student to join our school, right? And that student stays for, I think it's a minimum of 3 months.
3 months.
Will then get a free tablet from Esperanza Cyber.
Right.
And this goes for any student in our school, as long as your friends, your family members, acquaintances, church members, right? As long as they mention your name and say that they heard about Esperanza from you and that you requested them here, you'll be in the running to get this tablet.
Right.
And we're willing to give out multiple tablets, right?
Right.
So we're just trying to spread the word, make sure that you're sharing about, you know, your experiences here at Esperanza Cyber, telling them all the great things, making sure that they watch ECCS Live.
Right.
And they're you're doing all these different... Selfie. So make sure that your friends are, you know, those who are interested, everyone knows someone that might be interested, right? Put the word out, right? Yeah. Just spread the word. It could get you a free tablet.
Yeah. Yeah, a free tablet. And then, I mean, we might... We might even hit an issue where someone already got a free tablet, right?
Oh, no.
Let's say they're just like, you know, they're referring people and they're bringing people into our school. Then there'll be other prizes as well.
Yep.
So I just want to throw that out. But you got to imagine if we're giving out a tablet out as a prize, you got to imagine all the other good stuff that we'll have.
Absolutely.
So keep recommending people. Tell them about your experience here at Esperanza Cyber. Get the word out. We still have room here. We can fit a lot more students here.
Absolutely.
You know,
heck, we could fit
thousands
of students.
Yeah. So, like we said, recommend and let us know, and hopefully we see you walking around with a brand new tablet.
Yep. So make sure you're again following us on Facebook or liking our page on Facebook, right?
Yep.
/ Esperanza Cyber.
Yep.
Twitter @ Esperanza Cyber 1. You're late.
Yeah. Do it again.
@ Esperanza Cyber 1. There it is, in unison. And also on YouTube, Esperanza Cyber. We also have Instagram now. I forgot.
Oh, the Gram.
We got the Gram.
I forgot we're on the Gram.
We got IG now.
IG.
That's Esperanza_Cyber.
Okay.
Esperanza_Cyber. We're on Instagram. Follow us there. We'll be posting tons of pics. Selfies, right? Tons of selfies.
Yeah, tons of selfies.
So make sure you're following us on all the social media and keeping in contact with us, right?
Mm-hmm.
So thanks again for watching. Hope you guys enjoyed the episode and stay tuned for next week. See ya.